Welcome, let's start the class. So yesterday in the last class we were discussing about urban development. Okay, today we were discussing about what caused urbanization. Today we will discuss about early development of urbanization. Where the urbanization started, have you any idea? Yes. Have you any idea where urbanization first started? Yes? Anyone? Have you any idea where the urbanization first started? Early urban development. Yes, Varisha.
It was in Mesopotamia.
The Mesopotamia means the land between two rivers. Which were these two rivers? Tigris and Euphrates. Yes. It is called the Fertile Crescent. Yes, have you heard about the term the Fertile Crescent? And it was first, perhaps the first town was Ur. The word urban came from Ur. Ur. The first towns here, Ur. According to some historians, it is Uruk. Uruk or Ur. And the term urban came from Ur or Uruk. The urban settlement, the name of urban settlement, the classification of urban settlement came from Uruk. So what were the other centers? Which were the other centers? So Mesopotamia was the first center.
Babylon
was very near. Sumer, Babylon, they were in Mesopotamia at different points of time. Actually, there were five early urban herds, five early centers of early urban development, which are Mesopotamia, Mesopotamia. Any more? Do you remember? Any more? Can you see the board?
Yes, sir.
Mesopotamia? Yes, and? Any other name? It was Egypt.
One city was Ur.
Egypt. Yes. Any more? Yes, any more? Yes. Any other center of urban development?
You are?
Yes.
Ur
was in Mesopotamia. Mesopotamia, Egypt. Egypt, you know?
Yes,
one
sir.
Nearer home, very near to you, in India.
Harappa, Mohenjo-daro.
Yes, Indus Valley civilization. Indus Valley civilization. Any more? These are three urban herds, early urban herds. The urban development started in these areas mainly. Egypt, Indus Valley, Mesopotamia, yes? One was Mesoamerica. Mesoamerica. And another was Yellow River. These were five early urban huts. Remember these? Five early urban huts were there. Five early centers of urban development. Mesopotamia, Indus Valley Civilization, Egypt, Mesoamerica, and the Yellow River. Okay? These were five. Remember these. Three names you are familiar with: Mesopotamia, Egypt, and Indus Valley. And Mesoamerica and Yellow River are not so much heard by you, but these were the early centers of urbanization. So, first was, the earliest was, the earliest civilization was,
yes, Mesopotamia.
Mesopotamia, the land between two rivers. Which were these two rivers? Yes, which were these two rivers?
Tigris and
Euphrates. Dajla and Farat are called in Urdu. The land between these two rivers was fertile. Why urban development started here? We have talked about it.
Because of the river, sir.
Because of the river, what happened?
Just said the deposits from the river brings.
The soil was fertile. That's why it is called the Fertile Crescent. What is crescent?
Yes. Shape of a moon.
Shape of a moon, name. It is this shape. This shape land was there in Mesopotamia, and it was fertile. It was very fertile. Fertile means crop yield was high. Why it was so fertile?
Alluvial soil.
Every year, the rivers deposit alluvial soils, top humus layer. And why that layer is more fertile? Yes.
Because it's new soil.
It's new, and there are minerals there, and there are organic matter there that the food plant requires. Humus. You must have heard humus, this humus layer, and crop, when you grow a crop, the elements which micro elements, the elements which are needed by plants are depleted, because food, the crops take that, the plants take that. So the nutrients in the soil depletes, and if you go on like that, say 5 years, the soil will show infertility or less fertility, and the crop yield will reduce. So what do we do these days to replenish the soil?
Add different
fertilizers. We add fertilizers. We feed fertilizers to soil.
Maintain the stability.
Yes, to maintain the fertility, to maintain the supply of these nutrients, which the plants need. Okay. So, earlier civilization was Mesopotamian civilization. Okay. Have you heard the name Sumer, Babylon? Have you heard?
Yes, sir.
These were all in the Sumerian people, the Babylonian peoples. They were all in Mesopotamia. These existed there at different points of time. Sometimes they overlapped. The earlier civilization was there. So why urbanization started there? Yes. Anyone?
People started to settle.
People started to settle, but settlement doesn't mean the urban settlement. There are two types
Yes,
of
sir.
settlements: urban settlements and rural settlements.
So diversification of occupation happened. Animal herding was also.
Because the soil was fertile, an efficient agricultural system was developed. So people have had spare money to spend on fine things of life, and when they had spare money, then the diversification of economy started, and that is the prerequisite for urban development. Because what is urban? Urban is the settlement. Urban settlement is the settlement in which majority of people are dependent for their livelihood on the activities other than primary, means other than agriculture. Okay, so an efficient agriculture leads to urbanization. Okay, is that clear? We have discussed about it
yes, sir.
In earlier classes. Okay, so Mesopotamia was the first early civilization. Then it was Egypt. Egypt. Have you heard about Egypt?
Yes, sir.
Egyptian civilization. It is called the Gift of Nile. Why is that?
Again, played the role.
It is called the Gift of Nile. Why it is called the Gift of Nile?
Yeah, this statement was given by Herodotus. And
yes, why? Why he called Egyptian civilization the Gift of Nile?
So again, the river played the role because rivers give the transportation role and the settlements because of the soil fertility.
Yes, like Tigris and Euphrates, it replenishes the soil fertility every year by floods. Yes. Most of the Egyptian population is still living along the Nile. It's the Nile River. Most of the Egyptian population is still living along the Nile.
So
because the soil is
visible.
Fertile. Most of the early civilizations were river valley civilization. Why? Most of the early urban development areas where agriculture was efficient. Yes, why?
So because roads and other means of transport was not developed.
Yes, transport is the thing. And?
More
important than that.
Water was needed for
Water is needed. Irrigation is needed. Plants needs irrigation. And?
And agriculture practice.
Yes. And agriculture needs irrigation, and in those times we don't had many technology, we don't had canals, we don't had other technologies for irrigation. So the river valley, a river provided ready-made irrigation system. Yes, is that clear?
My connection went away, sir.
Yes, Atif.
My connection went away. Can you repeat once? Yeah,
you are right. Transport is a good reason, but more important than transport was irrigation. The plants needs, the crop needs irrigation, and these rivers provided irrigation to the crops. Okay. And remember, we are not talking about the crops. A plant grown in wild or in forest. We are talking about the controlled crops, because agriculture is controlled crops. So in Egypt also, Egyptian civilization was very rich. In Egypt also, an efficient agricultural system led to spare money, and that spare money provided for the development of and diversification of economy, and urban development took place. So early urban development areas were those areas where an efficient agricultural system was there. Isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then came Indus Valley civilization. Where is Indus Valley civilization?
Between Pakistan and India.
In Pakistan and India.
Northwest India.
If we talk about undivided India, then it was in India. Okay. So, Indus Valley civilization, there's an interesting thing about India. Normally, first, the development of rural areas took place in every part of the world. In India, in Indus Valley civilization, it was urban development. These were cities. Mohenjo-daro and Harappa were the cities, towns. So perhaps something in history happened, and that is a mystery, why Indus Valley civilization declined and urban civilization declined, and India gone again to rural agrarian economy, from urban economy to agrarian economy. There are many opinions about why Indus Valley civilizations declined. So we will take about Mesopotamia, Egypt and Indus Valley. Which was first? Indus Valley was early civilization, or Mesopotamia was early civilization?
Mesopotamia, sir.
Mesopotamia was earliest civilization. Indus Valley was also an ancient civilization, but around this continuum, 1,000 years passed. It was around 3,500, and it was around 2,500. 1,000 years has passed between these two civilizations. Although it was not one point of time. Indus Valley civilization, there are many sites. Harappa, Mohenjo-daro, Lothal, Roper, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Kalibangan, there are many sites. And which river fed it?
Indus
River. Indus Valley civilization was fed by Indus River. Okay. So, efficient agricultural system led to urban development. So, what prompted a development in town? Can you tell me? Why town started developing?
So, again, the surplus of agriculture and exchanges between other settlements.
Atik, the word town, the term town denotes some sort of fortification. There was a boundary around old towns. Have you seen it?
Yes, sir.
There was a boundary around old time. In Aligarh, if you go to old city, you can find remains of a boundary. And that correspond to the, you can infer the boundary from the term pole or gate, Delhi gate, Sasni gate. These gates were the openings in the boundary. The earlier towns were fortified. Boundary was there. Why? Can you tell me the boundary was there? Why there was a boundary?
For the invaders and animals?
Yes, yes. When you feel most need of security, and when you fortify your home, when?
When we have a flourished economy or money.
Yes, and when we have spare money, spare gold to protect, then we are afraid that raiders will take and they will take away our money. Okay. So, and there is one more civilization, Yellow River. Yellow River civilization was along
China.
In China, along
Mongolia.
Yes, Mongolia, China, yes. It was along the Yellow River. Huanghu, yes, Huanghu, or the Yellow River. Why that river is called yellow?
Because of the color of the river.
Sir, because of the soil.
Why? Yes, yes, because of the color of the river, but why it is of that color?
The fine sediments carried by the river is...
Carried from the four of deserts, Loess are carried to that river and it gives the color, yellow color to the river. That is the, an early urban civilization started there. It was arisen from a rural economy and it was a subculture. Why we call these civilizations? Yes.
Yeah. The earlier civilization started from...
Why this is called a civilization? Why it is called civil?
People started to settle permanently.
People started to settle and when they had time, then they started discussing finer things of life, philosophy, yes, administration development, government development, politics. It all originated in towns. These days we give a bad name to towns, but town was the town where the harbingers are early civilization. Civil society, the civil ideas originate in towns. The philosophy originates in town because the town people are wealthy. They have a spare time to think about these things. Yes? When we think about fine things of life,
we are not worried of collecting foods.
When we are basic needs are met. What are the basic needs of human being?
Food, clothes, shelter.
Food, clothes, shelter, then?
Security, maybe.
Security, yes, then? Yes. Then, yes,
services,
yes, there is a Maslow's hierarchy of needs. First we food, clothes, shelter, then when that need is met, then we aspire for inclusion in the society. When your needs are fulfilled, then you aspire for a place in society, a niche in society, yes? And last need is self-actualization need. When you are fed, when you are secure, when you have a place in society, then you start thinking that why we are here. That is self-actualization need. And sometimes it is called spiritual needs. Man starts thinking, why I am here? And that is the reason of birth of philosophy. So early philosophical development, early administrative development, we had to think about why we came, what, who should rule us. Plato Republic was written, that Aristotle was there, Socrates was there. The early philosophical development was started when we were fed. If you are hungry, then you cannot think about philosophy. Is that right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So early development of urban system led to civilization, and early development of urban system led to development of philosophy. Yes, so that is when you are fed, when you have a job, when you have a steady income, when you are clothed, when you are secure, then you start thinking about why I came in the world. Okay, so these are the five early urbans, and Mesoamerica. In Mesoamerica also, there was urban development. In Americas, who caused urban development? America. I'm talking about America as a continent.
The Europeans.
Europeans? Are you sure? Yes. Yes.
Indigenous peoples.
Yes, indigenous peoples. There was many. There were many well-developed civilization, and they had developed cities there. Inca civilization. They were developed. They were developed in sciences also. Inca civilization, other civilization. Machu Picchu is one of the wonders of the world. That was the city. Their city design was very accurate and very good. Highly developed city design was there in Mesoamerica or Americas. In India, also Indus Valley civilization is also known for highly developed cities. Highly developed city design. Have you heard about it?
Yes, sir. Grid shapes.
The grid was there.
Drainage.
There was development of drainage.
Swimming pool.
Our cities were well developed. The city design was very good. Do you know something about inventions of Mesopotamia? Sumerian people, many earlier inventions were made by Sumerians and Babylonians. Hanging gardens of Babylon, you must have heard about it. Have you heard about hanging gardens of Babylon?
Yes, sir.
Yes. And Egyptian civilization was also very developed. There was a system of Qanat. Anyone heard of Qanat? Have you heard about Qanat? Anyone heard about Qanat? Yes, Qanat. Yes, have you heard about Qanat? Have
so
anyone
half
heard?
Of the board is cropped out.
Board is not visible.
Okay.
Now is it visible or not? Just move focus.
Yes, now it is
visible. It is visible now.
Yes.
Qanat, have you heard about Qanat? Qanat is visible or not?
Yes, sir. Is it a tax system, sir?
Qanat was an underground canal system. Underground canal system. Think of it, in that era, around 2000 BC. Underground canal system. A canal network was there in Egyptian civilization because if you carry the water from canals, it evaporates. So they constructed an underground canal system. Tanakh. And the most beautiful development of riverfront cities was in, still it is in Iran. Riverfront cities. Where the river is there. Whereas the waterfront cities are riverfront cities. You can call it waterfront cities also. Most beautiful waterfront cities are in Iran still. The Egyptian civilization was also very developed. So what led to the decline of Egyptian civilization? There was a decline of Egyptian civilization. Perhaps it was the Mongol invasion. Mongols were a fierce army and they attacked many civilizations and many empires. If we talk about Mesopotamian civilization or Sumerian civilization, it was called the Age of Empires. Can you see? Age of Empires. What is an empire? Can you tell me? What is an empire?
System.
There are two terms, kingdom and empire. What is the difference between kingdom and empire? It was an age of empire in Mesopotamian civilization or in Sumerian civilization. Empire came and gone. Yes. What is an empire?
A group of kingdom, maybe.
A group of kingdom. What differentiates it from kingdoms? In India mainly there were kingdoms. But there was empire. Ashoka had an empire.
So if the land area is very huge, which covers...
is very huge, but the empire signifies that there are different people. Different type of people there. If you like Sumerians, like Assyrians, like Babylonians, they were different types of peoples, different tribes. People speaking different languages, people having different cultures. Okay. So if a king or if an administration rules over different kind of people, different people I am talking about, different people, different tribes, you can simplify, although it is not the same thing, but different type of people. Like Asian peoples are different, isn't it? And Africans are different from Asians, and Europeans are different from Asians and Africans. If someone rules on these three peoples, that is not a kingdom, that is an empire. In kingdom, same type of, largely the same type of people are there. Here the people are different races, speaking different languages, are there. Okay, so to summarize it, earliest urban development was in Mesopotamia, and there were five early urban hearths: Mesopotamia, Egypt, Indus Valley, Mesoamerica, and Yellow River. These were the main early urban development centers. Urban development.
Sir,
yes.
So the word Meso means intermediate. Why it is with the Mesoamerica?
In Mesoamerica also, it was between the North and South America.